Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Fun with Vintage Hi-Fi. Today I want to show you something, a little bit what you can do if you literally dig deeper in people's attics, garages and stuff. I came across this Vintage Techniques catalog. Nothing special, it's a catalog, very good, it's an original one with lot of stuff inside. But when I was coming across, looking in it, I came across this set. Techniques recommended this set, this Z11 system, containing B202 automatic turntable, stereo amplifier, Z11, Z11L tuner, RSM 215 cassette deck, which we reviewed before, three-way speakers, and the SH553 audio cabinet. And that's how it's supposed to look, which is pretty cool, because not very often you can look in a catalog and then look up and have exactly the same system, which is really, really cool. I didn't even realize I have the something which is literally part of the recommended by Techniques set. On the top we have the turntable. At the moment it does need a new belt, so I didn't replace the belt yet. Obviously we'll need a new belt to put it on, but otherwise it's in a pretty good nick, so I'm not sure how it will play yet. The stylus is with the cover. Then we have inside, when we open the cabinet, which is really, really cool stuff, we have a SUZ11 amplifier, and then STZ11L tuner, and the cassette player, which is which we reviewed before in one of my videos. It's M215. It's just really cool stuff. Let's start it. Let me present you guys how this works. You might be eager. So let's start the amp and tuner and cassette player. So let's start maybe with a little bit with the amp. Have obviously power on button, the jack to plug in, speakers main and remote, so whatever, and then a little bit of adjustment on the bass, treble. Those buttons really cool. You can make it like connect another tape player for it, so you can put it from tape one to tape two, or if it's depressed, is tape two to tape one, vice versa. Also source or dubbing on it, and on the other is tape monitor, like what you how you play, what you play from external sources, loudness, obviously to cut off the. And this is pretty cool one as well, a range. So on your display, I'll show you in a minute, it can, when it's pressed or depressed, it depends, it shows you the frequency in a peak power on LEDs. Balance, obviously, that's new. External IUX, like an input selector, tuner, and phono for the record player, and obviously volume one. And on tuner, we have signals FM stereo, signal strength LEDs show you how powerful is the your antenna aerial connection, MV the for the radio, FM super now the band FM, which is like gets you like very close to your frequencies when you're adjusting, and obviously the cutting of muting FM or to mono. Let's play tuner a bit. At the moment, yeah, as you see on the selector, when we move, let's tune it a little bit down, you see is losing completely strength, and then obviously when we tune it, when you get close to the station, you start lighting, and the strength of the signal, there we go, erase if it's a better one. I have just a normal small connection. And stereo, then when we press mono, there might be quality if you have so many distortions or playing on the mono, but obviously stereo is better. So that's literally how it go on the tuner. Really good one, very, very nice matching set. Let's try to find another station. Hopefully we can get something. There we go. There's another station. Not too powerful signal, you would have to get a really good RL one. That's really nice one, I really enjoy it. Yeah, how it works. And let me show you with cassette player. To cassette player, we just press the source. I have just a random tape on it. The cassette player we reviewed before, so maybe not too much on it. This is just to show you the whole set we play. Today I just put random cassette, classic music in it. And a little bit of loudness just to make it. Oop, the tape stops. Oh, must be really, really old tape. There we go. Let's eject that one. Well, maybe we can review a little bit more just to put it forward as a tension in the belts. The belts never been replaced in that set, so maybe that would be the option. Let's see when we get there. Back to radio for now. Oh, see you guys here. I just want to show you the range, and then obviously you cut if it's getting louder, so you don't basically peak maximum. So with this is gonna show you how it works. Yeah, and basically that's how it is. Let's play different tape maybe on that occasion. Let's change the tape to something else. Hopefully that will be better to play. There we go. You press. You're playing the speakers. There are three-way speakers. SB3030, also original on that set. Been kind of recommended. On the bottom of the cabinet, you have dividers for your records, for the record player or for singles, whatever. You know, at the moment I have all of them original instructions for manual for the whole set. So even for the speakers, as you see, that's what's really cool. And basically that's how it is. I just wanted guys you to see that you can literally come up and have a look and find it something which is in the proper Technics catalog. That's really amazing for me that I came across and never seen, you know, like having a catalog set in. That's really cool. It's really powerful also, you know. People might say, oh, it's an old vintage one, but how loud it can go. I'm only on the number 2 on the volume, and it's already very powerful there. So probably connecting some vintage CD into it, or obviously record player, you can have a quality and stuff. So that will be a very useful part for them. The speakers, obviously have the front covers. Yeah, in the rear, maybe I can show you a little bit in the rear, just to make sure you guys see it, how the connection is. Speakers, front remote, and all of this phono for your record player, IX for the external maybe CD, and for tape 1, tape 2 to be connected. Down then this is obviously a radio and the tape player. Cabinet is really, really nice with the glass front. That's really cool one. You can just close it by pushing magnet there, and automatically goes up when you're pushing double to it. That's basically how it is, guys. With the radio at the moment a little bit better, you know. Hopefully you guys enjoy it. Like I said, sometimes we can come up with something remarkable because it's literally that set matching it, and I really love it. It makes me a little bit of jiggle that we have a set which, you know, is straight out of catalog. I actually even have seen the receipt for it, which was with the instructions. Somebody paid over 300 British pounds for it in the originally when he paid from the shop. So that's pretty cool. Anyhow, guys, hopefully you enjoy it with it and see what we can come up with next time. Cheers.